question on the way one dresses, on the way the girl dresses, on the way she talks, on the way she, you know, on the way she has friends. Why every, each and every convention is there on the girl, not on the boy?
You are narrating only a very small part of the story. What's your name?
Monica.
Sit. Monica. Monica is painting a picture where a girl is being raped and thousands are watching. And she says, why is it so? Why is this society such that it teaches a girl to not to be raped, but hardly seems to tell men to not to rape? No, that's not really factual. This society is teaching both the man and the woman. It is teaching the man to rape and the woman to get raped. It is teaching everybody. It is not only teaching the man, it is teaching the woman as well. And it is not only teaching the man to rape, it is also teaching the woman to rape. What do you think? Women are not rapists? Do you understand rape? What is rape? What is rape? Whenever you approach anything in any state other than love, it is called rape. A rape is not limited to sexual intercourse. Look at the way you handle your registers. That is rape. These sounds that are hearing all around, this is rape. Rape is a much wider thing. Rape is a state of mind. When you are raping a woman, you are consuming her, right? You are looking at her just as a body, as a material to be consumed, right? Anything that you look at just as a body, as a material to be consumed, is rape. And women are raping. They are raping very much. Look at the way people spread dirt around. Is that not rape? Are you not raping the earth? Look at the way we consume our rivers. Are we not raping our rivers? Who told you that rape is merely a sexual activity? Rape is a state of mind. A mind that cannot love will only rape. And we all rape. Please do not think that rape is limited to a few men. No. This entire society rapes. This entire society rapes. Is there anything that we do not rape? So, let us not be particularly sad when men rape a woman. Because we are anyway raping everything and everybody all the time. Men are raping and women are raping. And this society has only taught us rape. We are all rapists. And we do not exempt anybody. We rape small animals. We rape our own children. We rape our clothes. We rape the classroom. We rape the pen that we are holding in our hands. We have not spared anything. We are raping all the time. But we do not see, Monica, that the entire thing is so all-pervasive. We are bothered only when the act becomes very sexual and very explicit. Then our morality suddenly wakes up. Then we say, oh, something bad is happening. But that is happening all the time. You are blind if you cannot see it. It is happening all the time, but you never object. Look at what is happening in your movies all the time. You will not object when all those gross themes and songs are there in your movies. You will not object. In fact, you will purchase a 300 rupees, 500 rupees ticket to watch the same movie, right? And because you are paying money to the producer of that movie, he will produce more such movies that are full of rape. And then when people watch those movies and go ahead and rape, who is responsible? Who paid that producer to produce that movie? You paid that producer, right? Do you not watch all these movies that contain all these raunchy numbers? That are explicitly sexual? Do you not watch them? Have you not paid money to watch them? Then who is responsible if a woman gets raped? Why do you say that only four people must be hanged? Everybody must be hanged. We all are responsible. It is just that four people did the act. But behind those four people is the entire society. If you want to hang, hang the entire society. And that entire society includes women as well. Hang the women as well. They are equally responsible. Are they not raping? Why do you say that women are the victims? Women are as much perpetrators of this crime as are men, this entire society. We rape our own bodies, don't you see that? When we use our bodies just as material, that is rape. And don't we look at our bodies just as material, things to be displayed, exhibited? Don't we do that? And that includes both men and women. When you say that my eyes are objects that must attract other people, when my eyes, my hair, my entire body is something that must attract other people, then you have raped your own body. Because you have reduced your own body to just an object. Whatever is objectified is raped. And do not think that you can contain rape, reduce rape by making some laws or by hanging a few people. Till the mind of the individual does not change, rape will not stop. Rape does not start in the body. Rape starts in the mind. Don't you see that? Rape does not start in the body. The body only expresses rape. Rape starts in the mind. And it is a collective mind. It is a social mind that rapes. That mind needs to be changed. Otherwise, your laws and your policing will be of no help. Till the time you have these television serials, till the time you have a consumerist mindset, till the time you live only as a material being, till the time you are ambitious and greedy and full of fear, the raping mind will persist. But no, you will say being ambitious is all right. But rape is bad. If being ambitious is all right, then it will inevitably result in rape. You do not understand the origin of the whole thing. You just want to cut down the leaves of the tree. You do not understand where the roots are. And unless you look at the roots, just cutting the leaves again and again will be of no help. There are 1,000 leaves. How many leaves will you cut? And even if you cut them, they'll grow again. Because you are not prepared to look at the roots of the whole thing. This mind is the root. This mind that just looks at the world as something to be consumed. I want to consume. I want to eat more and more. I want to satisfy my body. That is what is rape. What else do you do in a shopping mall? You consume and you satisfy your body. What will look good on me? What can I eat? What is nice to touch? What kind of smell? And do you think now this mind, can it resist raping? It rapes. And for God's sake, do not think that only that incidence of rape is violent where a woman is being raped and 1,000 people are looking. Rape is happening every day, every time. What do you think? What is happening in all these married relationships? The husband is raping the wife all the time. And the wife is prepared to be raped. The wife is looking at the husband's body as an object. And the husband is looking at the wife's body as an object. And that is rape. Is there real love? No, it is merely rape. But then you will not call it rape because there is no FIR and because it is within the institution of marriage. So you will not say it is rape. But it is rape. Whatever you see all around is nothing but rape. So do not be too disturbed when you come across a particularly bloody incident. That is not just one incident. It is happening all the time. 99% of the population of this world is just a product of rape. A very wise man in the last century said that we all are illegitimate children. That we all are illegitimate children because none of us are products of love. And whosoever has not been born out of love is actually an illegitimate child. Doesn't matter whether the parents are married or not. So he said we all are illegitimate children because there is only rape. There is no love. The husband is raping the wife is raping the husband. Body to body. Stop rape. And there is no way, no better way to stop rape than to stop raping yourself. See this thing very clearly and take a vow that I will not rape. I will not rape anything around me or anybody around me. I will not use anybody. I will not objectify anything or anybody. Everything is breathing. Even the stone is breathing. Even the stone is pulsating with life. Do not look even at the stone as if it is only an object. That is rape. Do not think that the river is just flowing water. That is rape. The river is a living entity. The river is alive. And if you do not see that, you will end up raping the river. And that's what we have done to our rivers. We think it is just flowing water. What do you think? A tree is just the roots and the stem and the leaves? No. A tree lives. Don't rape it. Look at your food, how you kill animals and eat them. Is that not rape? If rape is just the violation of body, are we not violating the bodies of animals all the time? Tell me. A woman's body is exposed and penetrated and you say that is rape. And what else are you doing to a chicken? Are you not cutting its body apart? And is that not rape? Is that not rape? But then you have no qualms in eating chicken. You do not realize what you are doing. So to begin with, stop raping. Everything, every object, every person, everything that you can perceive is worthy of respect. It deserves your love. Treat it with love. When you touch it, your touch must be sacred. Do not touch it as if it is just something to be eaten, to be had. Touch only with love. Are you eating it? And that is not rape. All right?